Hello, I'm Graham Horton. Welcome to today's video. Now, today's video I've titled A Quick Build. Now, I love to design and build equipment, and hopefully in this series you'll get some ideas that you can actually build yourself. Now, quite a few years ago I built a little synchronisation device to allow me to use things like pocket audio recorders and sync the audio to the camera track. Particularly useful for those with a Panasonic Lumix FZ80 or 82 camera that doesn't have a remote audio input socket, so you are reliant on using external recorders if you want to get the best audio. You can of course use the camera track as sort of the synchronisation to allow you to line up the external audio with the camera track. So to enable me to do that, I built this little box which has a push button, there's a 3-volt coin cell inside, an LED light and a piezoelectric transducer. Now I put the circuit for that in my photographic blog and I've linked that in the video description below if you wanted to see the circuit. This works very well, but there's only one problem. The button is exposed and quite often when it's in my camera bag, it will bang against something and set itself off, or it will rest on one side and continuously beep. So if I just press that, you can see the action. So that would be my synchronization. I would start the video and then I would just do, and then I could see that in the waveform, so I could synchronize the light and the sound to give me a perfect synchronization. But I wanted to improve on that, and over Christmas time I noticed that quite a few of the Christmas lights came with a button on the packaging which says "Tried Me," and something like this. This is a little button. Inside is again a 3-volt coin cell, a little button, and it came out to a little lead which then would power the lights. So by putting a red LED in here, when this button's pressed, the LED light will come on. Because of the internal resistance of the coin cell, it doesn't really affect the LED in terms of overpowering it. So we're still going to maintain something like a 20 milliamp current flow through the LED, which isn't going to do it any harm. The other part of the build will be a small piezoelectric transducer. And again, these are available on Amazon. I'll put links to all the products in the video description below. So by wiring the LED and this piezoelectric transducer to this 3-volt supply, we can have a build similar to this. This was a different type of Try Me button, but it's exactly the same thing. It's got a protective guide around there so your fingers can't depress the button. So this is my sort of second attempt, if you like. So again, got the effect. But when I noticed these on the latest packaging, I thought it much easier to build a device with this button than it is with the necessary bits that go with this. You've got a different type of casing and a different type of connection. So this would be much easier if you can get a hold of this. So let's start the build, and what we need is a small plastic box to enable us to build this into. Here I just found a small plastic box within my bits and pieces, but any plastic box which will support the push button and the transducer. You need a drill, of course, just to drill the holes. I need this 1-inch hole saw, which is designed for this diameter of button, soldering iron and hot glue, that sort of thing. So what we're going to do is first of all drill a hole in the top of this box, which will be a 1-inch hole, 25 millimeters, to take the push button. So I've got my plastic box, just going to put a little bit of masking tape over the top there so I can mark it to give me the positioning. And we obviously want it in the centre of the device, so this box measures 59 millimetres, so 29 and a half would be the centre line. And if it's a 1-inch button, let's make it 25 millimetres down to give me a little bit of clearance. So that would be my marking point for the drill. So this is a 1/4-inch shank cutter. So what I'm going to do first of all is to drill a smaller hole in there to give me a pilot. So let's just drill that. Yeah. So we've now got the centre hole, and now we'll drill the 1-inch hole for the push button. So again, using that to centre it. So now we've got a perfect 1-inch hole in the centre of the lid. So I can take this masking tape off now, as it's served its purpose. So the push button will go through that hole like so. So we've got the push button. We can then just put a dab of hot glue on there to hold it in place. It gives us a mounting point for when we want to change the coin cell in this device. So there we have the button in the device. We'll also need holes in the front of the device to carry the piezoelectric transducer. It's only a sort of 3mm hole at the most in there, so we're just going to drill a small hole, and we want a 3mm hole to mount the LED as well. So we'll mark across here the position for the transducer and the LED. So again, we'll mark the center point for the transducer. Again, 29mm. And the actual depth of the box is 25. So if we make this 12, like so, that would be the hole for the transducer. And on the same center line, we'll have the LED light. And we'll just mount that somewhere there. So let's change the bits in the drill. And again, I'll drill the first hole for the output port of the transducer. And then we'll drill the hole for the LED. And I'll just make this hole the right diameter for the LED. Again, the tape has served its purpose, so we can get rid of it, clean up a little bit. So I'm just going to use the hot glue to hold that button in place, just a couple of dabs around the outside edge. We'll hold that in place while it cools down. Well, that's just setting, let's put a bit of weight on there. We're going to use these piezoelectric transducers. These are very small devices. The polarity is the positive is the longer leg of the device, negative obviously the shorter leg. I've prepared two cables here so that I can attach it to the device and to the button itself. So the first thing I'm going to do is to actually tin these wires. Just clean the tip of the soldering iron. And we'll just tin these two wires. Just twisted the strands together so they don't separate. And we'll just tin either end. And similarly, I'll tin the legs of the device, so just a bit of blue tack to hold that in place. And Providing you don't have the heat on the legs for too long, then you should be okay. There's a one. Just turn this over. Do the negative. So there we have the negative. Now I'm going to put the leads onto the device. So again, we'll just attach the leads onto the device, or a steady hand. So there's negative, and the longer lead is the positive. Like so. If you were being really pedantic, you could put some heat sleeving over those cables to stop any shorts, but it's unlikely in this situation. So we've soldered the positive lead to the anode, the negative lead to the cathode of the LED, and that will go into the cable from the button. The negative of the battery from the button is marked with a tracer, and here it's like a silver line throughout the cable, and that will be the negative. So that will be the negative and the black wire of the transducer and LED. That just plugs in there like so. We can test that now. We've got the button, so we can see we've got the LED and obviously the audio as well. So all that remains now is for us to mount the LED and the transducer in the box. The 3mm hole is a nice tight fit for the LED, so we'll just push the LED into place like so. And for the transducer, I'm just going to add a little touch of hot glue to the outside edge. Like so, not so much that it squeezes out and covers a hole, so we'll align that with the hole in the case so the sound will come out without restriction. Just hold that in place for a second while that cools down and sets. And while we're doing that, I'll just put a little blob of hot glue to stop the LED moving back should it get pushed in our case. This hot glue gets everywhere. So trying to align the hole to the hole in the case. And we'll just add a little bit more glue now to the outside, now that it's set. So all you need to do now is to put on the lid of the box, like so, and we've got our completed project. So now we've got our button, which we can press, and the LED and sound will happen simultaneously. So if you have a audio recorder and using that to capture audio separately, then with this synchronization device, you're going to be able to see the LED. If you've got a camera track, then obviously you can synchronize the peaks together. If you haven't got a camera track, then you can actually see the LED light and synchronize that with the blips from the audio. So you can synchronize those in post-production to align the audio and the video. So there you are, my quick build for an audio video synchronization device for your cameras if you want to have external audio recording. Hope you found that useful. If you're a new viewer and you're liking what you see, why not subscribe and hit that bell notification icon, and then you'll be advised when I upload new projects. I've got a lot more quick build ideas in the pipeline, so if you want to be seeing what those are, do subscribe. Also, check out my newsletter. I publish most of these things in the newsletter under the Electronics for Photographers section, so you'll be able to find out what I've been up to. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.